Martin Luther King Jr. once said, "Never, never be afraid to do what's right, especially if the well-being of a person is at stake. Societies are small compared to the wounds we inflict when we look the other way. The shocking number of cruelty cases reported daily on the television, in the newspapers, on the internet, are never reported completely, and then most of the cases go unrecognized, and they're never actually heard about what actually happened. The average cruelty an animal suffers is pain and silence because of our inhumane actions. Today I would like to share with you all more about this severe problem currently happening around the world, and hope that by the end of my speech I inspire you to try and do something about it. Animal cruelty is a serious problem, whether it is animals used for clothing, experimentation, entertainment, pets, or food. It is all abuse. Every day in countries around the world, animals are fighting for their lives. They are enslaved, beaten, and kept in cages and chains just to make them perform for the human entertainment. They are harmed and crammed in tiny cages so that we can kill them and eat them. They are born, poisoned, blinded, and cut up alive just in the name of science. Over 56 billion animals are killed every year by humans, and more than 3,000 animals are killed every second in slaughterhouses around the world, according to the Animal Equality website. Animals raised in factory farmeries and slaughterhouses endure almost unimaginable suffering, cruelty in raising, transporting, and killing these animals for food. The pigs go insane when cows are no longer useful. They are taken for slaughters to make your burgers. Workers in slaughterhouses are poorly paid and they're unmonitored, and they go beyond the standard of use. They forcefully crowd all the animals in trucks, and they go through all weather extremes without food or water. And once they get to the slaughterhouses, their throats are cut, they're dropped in scalding hot water, they're skinned and hacked apart, they're hung and stung by electrical tongues while still completely conscious. So another problem that is currently happening are fur farms. They use the cheapest and cruelest methods for killing these animals, including suffocation, electrocution, gas, and poison. They're even skinned alive. On the website, Animal Equality states that approximately 35 animals are killed and skinned to make a single coat, and the fur industry overall kills 30 million animals. Those 30 animals a year. In countries such as China and India, welfare laws for animals are non-existent or non-enforced. Cruelty and how it is happening. Next, I'm going to tell you some of the causes. So, giant corporations make more money by squeezing a lot of animals into tiny cages. And then the workers there, since the corporations don't even care, the workers are asked to cause these pain on the animals for the cheap and the demand of the product. And then according to a coping mechanism on the website, One Green Planet said workers become desensitized to the misery these animals live, And then many, many cases, we've seen that workers are caught abusing these animals really poorly. So how are they supposed to care if the giant corporations don't care to begin with? So I just previously talked about some of the causes. Lastly, what can we do to help stop animal cruelty? There are important millions of ways that we can do it. Animals are caught up in these factory farms and should have at least a decent life. Yes, one bad day when they're gone is slaughter, but that doesn't mean that they have to live their lives in misery and privation. Wayne Purcell states on animal factories and abuse of power on TED Talks that one big solution is human creativity. The animals that can move should be allowed to move, and we should have common sense and make conscious choices that have better consequences for our animals. Like try Meatless Monday, or choose higher welfare products, or urge major corporations, because we're a capitalist economy and they have a big influence on our behavior. New York is the only state that has banned fur farms. So they've set the example for all of the states, and the United States and all countries should ban these fur farms. These animals are helpless and they need us. Or should I say we're helpless, because without them we don't have food, we don't have fur, we don't have anything. There are many solutions and alternatives that we can do that usually cost less money and take less time. We have to get help and be responsible. We have to be leaders and we have to spread the word. So in conclusion, today I share with you all on this serious topic about animal cruelty and how it is currently happening around the world. And I hope that by the end of my speech, you're willing to help and spread the word, and that I inspire you to do something. And as a reminder, animal cruelty is a serious problem. And second, I talked about some of the causes, and last, what can we do to stop it? So in conclusion, and remember that we have to be mindful of every one of these creatures, and we have to take care of them so we can share our world.